So I know a lot of students, they don't like to use the completing a square method to solve a quadratic equation where it's not factorable. They will just use the quadratic formula. But there are situations that you really have to know how to complete the square, such as this one right here. We have a second degree equation, meaning we have x squared, and here we also have y squared. We would like to investigate what this is. I will tell you, it's a circle. But in order to realize that it's a circle and finding its center and its radius, we will have to complete the square, not just once, but twice. So let me show you guys how it goes. Firstly though, I will tell you, know that when we have the equation x minus h squared plus y minus k squared, if this is equal to r squared, this is the equation of a circle in a standard form, and you will know that the center is at h, k. And one thing to be careful though, you have the negative h here and then the negative k here, but the center is h, k. And we also know the radius is r. And once you know the center of the circle and the radius of the circle, you can graph the circle. And we will have to complete a square in order to put this equation into this form. Not just one time though, but twice. So let me show you how it goes. First, we have x squared. I'm going to put this together with the next x, which is the 8x, so plus 8x. And I leave a space because you know we are going to use the magic number. Then, continue, we have the plus y, and then put together with minus 2y, and then leave a space here. And that's equal to, when we have a number, you know, move that to the other side, just add 8 to both sides, we get plus the 8. So this is how we get ready. Now, to complete the square right here, first we have 1 in front of the x squared already, which is good. Proceed by looking at the 8. We take half of it, which is 1 half times 8. Put that 8 right here. And then square that little result, which is just 4 squared, and that will give us 16. So that means we will have to add 16 here. And whatever you do to one side of the equation, you do the same thing to the other side. Next, we are going to complete the square for the y. And we focus on this number, and yes, we have the 1 in front of the y squared. So we take 1 half of negative 2. Half of negative 2 is just negative 1. Square that is just 1. So we're just going to add 1 here, and of course, do the same thing to the other side. That said though, notice that these 3 terms, we can factor it, and it's a perfect square. It's just x plus 4 times x plus 4. We can write that as x plus 4 squared. For this, first make sure that you put on the plus right away, and then you factor it, you will get y minus 1 squared. And one thing to notice that the plus 4, it can be from here, and then the minus 1, you can just look at it from here. It always works. And then right here, you can see 8 plus 16 plus 1 altogether is 25. But you have to know that this right here is 5 squared. So this is the equation in the standard form. And then with that, you can say that's a circle. And the center, it's going to be at, what? You'll see a positive 4 here, but it's actually minus negative 4. So the center is actually at negative 4. For the h, right? Because h has to be negative 4 in order to have negative negative to get the positive. You just always do the opposite. And if you have minus 1, it's just going to be positive 1. That's the center. And the radius is just equal to 5, not 25, 5. All right, so that's it. And of course, at the end, I'll give you guys the circle. Let's have a look. To do it, I will put it down like this. Okay, somewhat like this. Okay, so let's say here is negative, let's say negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4. And then just do a few more of this. Okay, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, something like that. Center, negative 1, comma 4, negative 1. Negative 4, comma 1, it's right here, center. For the radius, what we are going to do is, starting from the center, move to the left 5 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, put that. Move up 5 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then move to the right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then go down 5 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, something like that. Right here, do not draw a diamond though. No, because it's a circle. Connect the dots. These are like your guide. There you go. That's a circle.